Welcome to the Django Project, DJ Blogger. This tutorial is part of a YouTube Django Project playlist, which you can access in the video description. You can watch the whole course from the very beginning. If you enjoy this course and would like all the updated tutorials and associated code samples and more, you can check out this course and other courses this project features at Udemy. The link to the course is in the video description. This section of the course is dedicated to building this single post page. So let's go through the process by, first of all, identifying what it is that we're trying to build. So we want to allow users to click on any post, and then that would then take them to that individual post, and they can go ahead and read that post. So you can see that this is the individual single post page. You can see that the characteristics are slightly different from what we set up in the index page or the home page. There's going to be a menu on the left-hand side. And in addition to that, we are going to have a menu on the right or a section on the right-hand side for additional sidebar components, one of them being something that we've already created, the tag cloud. We will also build another component, which is going to be utilized as a way of allowing users to view other posts related to that particular author, in this case, just the admin. So we'll show maybe up to maybe 5 or 6 different posts related to that author also in this sidebar. So let's take a look at it in terms of how it folds into a mobile view. So you can see that the right-hand side disappears. You can see that everything is nicely centered. Now notice that the left-hand side navbar also changes to a top, so it goes from a vertical navbar to a horizontal navbar. Something else we need to change there. Notice that we are using a different logo as well. And you can see that we have, in addition to that, the drop-down ready for any menu items. And then when it gets into a smaller mode, you can see the text is scaling. And notice that we are using a separate text there for the reading content. So let's first understand how this is going to work in terms of the components that are needed in order to get this working. So we're going to need some way of clicking on our existing posts. If you remember, let's just refresh this page. If you remember, we added our posts here. We wrapped them in A tags, link tags. So that should then enable us to click on it. So we're going to need a link. We're going to need to make a link from every individual post and have that then utilized in the browser. And that will then take us to that single page. So then we want to create a new single page and then utilize this data here in order to collect that individual post and put it onto the page. So that's really the flow here. Click on a post, utilize that post information in the URL up here, and then go to the single page and then grab that data or use that data to then query the database and extract that individual post and display that data onto the page. If we take a look, let me just close all this down. If we take a look inside of our blog app here and go into our models, you can see that we added the slug. So we're going to use that data, extract that data and utilize that to then show those individual posts. So in addition to that, what we probably want to do is to set up a way of creating a URL based upon that slug. So in our models here, let's go ahead and create a new function. Let's call this get absolute URL. So we're going to be able to call this and then get the URL of an individual post. So that's how we're going to get the URL. So let's return a reverse. We get the post single. So we need to get the link of the single post, if any, and then we need to pass an argument to it. This will make more sense in a minute when we build the URL. So self.slug. So what we're doing here then, we're creating this function inside of our model, which we can call, and we can then build a link to that particular post that we're trying to show. So we're going to need to import that in. So I should be able to just hover over quick fix And you can see that it does give me some options here. If I did have the Django app installed, that would probably include the correct information, the import, to save me having to actually type in the import here. So let's go ahead and just add that from the utils, from django.urls. Let's import reverse. There we go. So remember, you can look this up on the Django documentation. Reverse is just a tool which will be able to take in parameters, which will then format and build a URL that we can then utilize. Right, so let's start with the URL. So let's get into our URLs. And you can see that the name of the URL is already going to be called post single. That's what we're going to be calling it, the name. So let's create a new path here. So this path, we're going to need to create a new path for it. So we are going to use a home page. So we're simply going to utilize, if we go back to our page here, like we've got here. So we want to basically just extend that. And this is where the post name is going to be placed. And then that would take us to the post single page. So that's what we're aiming for here. So all we need to do is pass in this case, a slug. So let's type in slug and then post. Okay, slash. So what we're doing here, if for example, if there is any data here, if there is any characters here after this, and we send this to Django, it's going to then match this right here. Because remember, this is basically just empty. That's a home page. But if we do have something here, that's going to be captured. So we want to connect this then to a view. So we're going to create a new view. Views dot post single. And then let's give this a name. Equals. Now notice here I'm not using as view because I'm going to show you how to create a simple function based view for this. So we're going to call this post single. Okay, so we're going to use a function based view for this. So let's go into our views, a very simple function based view. So we need to call it post single. Now I'm simply just doing this just to show you how to build a simple function-based view. You can turn this in, and this is, I guess, a little bit of homework for you. See if you can turn this into a class-based view. Right, so let's remember that we are passing in something here. So this text here is going to be captured. Let's call it this here. And then we can then refer to it as, I'll say that again. So this text here is going to be captured in post. This is the type of data that we're using. So here I could have, for example, an integer and so on. So this is going to be a slug type of data. So that's the type of data that it's expecting. So this could also be a string, for example. So it's just defining the type of data that we're passing in. So it's the slug. So we've now storing this in post. So if we go into the view, you can see that we're passing this into this function, that data. So then we can use that data to build a query. So now we have the data. So let's imagine we typed in something here and that's the name of the post. We've captured that now in post. So now what we can do is we can take that data and we can get that individual post from a database. So get object. Or 404 post is the model, slug equals post. So what we're doing here is we're going to run a query on the post table and we're looking for where this slug, remember this name here, this should be a corresponding slug of one of our posts. So we capture that, we bring it in, and then we utilize it then to check it against the posts in our database. Now, we can also have, for example, status equals published. So we only want to find a post that's published. We don't want to show a post that hasn't been published. So this get object, we need to add that in. So we need to bring this in the top here. So that's from the shortcuts. So let's get rid of render because we're not using that. So let's bring in get object or 404. So essentially, if we don't produce an object, that's going to return a 404 error. So if it doesn't exist in the database, we're going to get a 404 error, and that's going to be displayed on the page. Right, so with that in place, we now have a way of collecting that specific post. So now we can go ahead and, for example, return that. So let's return. Now we're going to return a render. So we need a render. So a render is basically a function which is going to put everything together and send back a HTTP response. So we need to the request information. We need, for example, a template. So that's going to be in blog. In our templates area, let's take a look. So template blog, we're going to put it here. So just blog slash single.html. And then we need some data to send back to the template, which is going to be the post data. So just an individual post. So we're going to grab the individual post based upon the parameters that we pass in. We'll grab that and then we'll send that back to the template so we can then display that information. And there we go. That's a simple function-based approach for creating a view. Now, like I said, if you can do, give it a go, have a look at the documentation, see if you can convert this into a class-based view. So now we have that in place, let's go ahead and add our new template. Right, so in templates, in blog, let's go ahead and create a new file. It should be called single.html. Remember, we're just following this view here. So on this single page, let's just remember that it's going to have some slightly different properties from the index page. So we're not going to be importing, for example, the navbar in this case. We're going to build a separate navbar, which is going to act slightly differently. As you've already seen in the preview here, it's going to be a left-hand side horizontal. Vertical, and then it's going to go horizontal. Let's first determine, though, before we build all the different components, because there's a few different components, and I will break that down into a few tutorials here. Let's first of all just check to make sure that we can access the data based upon what we've got so far. Now, there's no need to loop, because remember, all we're returning is one post. So on the single page here, we don't necessarily need to loop anything out. We just need to make sure that we know the context that of the data that's being passed through. So we can access this data via the word post. So post dot, and then we want to access maybe the author. Let's just wrap that up in a div for now. Okay, so we're going to need, in addition to that, the post dot updated at. So we're going to say updated at, so we can see when the post was last updated. We use a nice little filter here like we did previously. So we'll specify the date, so the month and the day. That's what we're going to display. And then we'll go ahead and add the title, which is just going to be a H1 tag. So this is going to be the post title. And then finally the H2 tag, which is going to be the subtitle. Post dot subtitle. And then we need the actual content, of course. Right, so let's go for post dot content for now. We are going to make some changes to this, and we'll look at that later on in this section. But let's just go for the post content for now. Let's take a look to see if this is working. So I'm going to just add something random here, and you can see that we return a 404. Oh no, error refused. Okay, site can't be reached because the server's not turned on. So let's turn the server on. Okay, home page, random. There we go. So you can see that we return a 404 because the slug here, this information doesn't match any of the posts. So let's go back into our data here. let's take a look at now making a link from the index page so it automatically sends us to our new single page. Right, so now we can utilize, if you remember, at the start, we in our models, we created this way of getting a URL based upon a slug of that particular post. So now we can utilize that. So let's go into, our index. So our templates, our index page. Let's scroll down to where our data is. Now remember, we are including this here in this element here. So in actual fact, we need to go into components and our post list element. So just drop that down. So this is where we find our individual posts. Now at the moment, we are utilizing, okay, I see a typo there. Notice that if you have this at the end, that's why it wasn't creating a link. That would make sense. So let's try that out. So now when I move the mouse over, you can see that it does work successfully. For some reason, that snuck in there for some reason. So here we have the link. So we need to generate a link now based upon each and every post. So to do that, we're simply just going to use the function that we created here in a model. So we're going to simply just call this, and then that's going to get the URL of the post single, which is just the homepage, of course. And then it's going to get the slug, self slug. So the slug related to that particular post. So let's add this right here. So in our href, we're going to wrap that up in our doubles. And then we're going to say post dot get absolute underscore URL. I think that was correct. Okay. So let's give that a go. Let's go back to our page. Let's restart. So let's click on a button and there we go. So you can see that our code here is incorrectly created. That's why we're seeing this here. So it looks like we've got an error in our code. So let's go back to the single page. So we forgot the end curlies on there. So let's just add that back, refresh. So you can see we now have all the information on that particular page. So whatever I click on, that should now correspond to those individual posts. Board camera realize, yep. So I'm just checking the titles. So it does look like it's working correctly. So now we're going to build this three column setup. Now we're going to use this template, this three column template, on multiple pages. So I want to make an individual component, which just includes this setup here, the building blocks for this page. So I can then utilize it on multiple pages. And then any page I want to use this setup, I can import this in, this template in, and just add into these sections, the components related to that particular page.